Now we connect with OmniBC legislative reporter Kim Emerson live from Victoria. Hey, Kim.
Good morning.
Big morning today. Big day for Christy Clark. What's at stake for our premier today?
Well, pretty much everything. Her political future, for one. And then for her party, the smug bragging rights and the ability to rub it in the faces of the opposition and the media about how wrong we were about the general election. So there's an awful lot riding on this. She needs to win this so that she can take a seat in the legislature, lead her government, lead the party, lead for the next 4 years. She loses, it becomes a real problem. You've got all kinds of issues if she loses, because then it becomes, does she decide to stay with the party? Does she decide to run again in a third election? Does the party decide to keep her and allow her to do that? So there's an awful lot at stake here, and she's been campaigning harder for this election than she did for the by-election in Vancouver Point Grey and the general election in Vancouver Point Grey. She's actually even showed up to a couple of all candidates meeting, which she's never done before. So she knows how much is at stake here herself.
What weight should we put on the advance polls being so strong in the Westside Kelowna by-election, the 5,700 plus turning out?
Normally you get about 4,600, and they've got a 20% increase here, and everybody's trying to figure out exactly what that means. I mean, does that mean that the opposition's been able to muster more people to get out and vote? Does that mean that the Liberals have been able to get their people out to vote? Nobody's quite sure at this point, but even privately, the NDP does not believe that they are going to win this seat, but they are still baffled a little bit by that extra turnout for the advance poll, a 20% increase. And just if I could just add one more thing to that, the cost of this by-election, $450,000. 45,000 people eligible to vote. Works out to about $10 a vote for the price of democracy for the premier to have this by-election.
That's some crazy math, Kim Emerson. Let's talk about Angus Reid weighing in on what went wrong with the political polls during the election campaign in May and being so backwards.
Yeah. I have to shake my head on this. I mean, I know that the media, me included, we all relied on polls and the polling data because for a long time it seemed like it was accurate, it was going the right way. This was so drastically and dreadfully wrong. And it's taken them 7 weeks to come out. And essentially what they've done is they've blamed people under 35 years old for not showing up to the polls like they said they would. This isn't a shock to anybody because that's the way it's been going for decades. Voter turnout has been going down, and voter turnout amongst those under 35 has been going down even more. Elections BC recognized that. They tried to do all kinds of things to get voter turnout to come up. But for Angus Reid to come out at this point, and, you know, they're a private company and they've got to try and have clients and do business, but I think most media people have kind of dismissed them at this point because it was so wrong and the media ended up with so much egg on their face over the general election. Nobody's paying a lot of attention.
We're running out of time, but I want to ask you this, because we seem so distracted with the goings-on of this by-election, we haven't even really heard what's happened so far at the BC legislature this session.
Let me tell you something. You have missed absolutely nothing. They have been debating budget. They're doing it so much that they've got it in the main legislative chamber, and then they've got it in a secondary chamber, and if they have to, they'll put it into a third chamber as well. They want to debate the budget. They want to get out of there by July 27th, but the premier may not be able to sit because there's still about 20 days of counting that has to go on before her seat becomes official, should she win tonight.
Wow, it just all seems so red tape filled. Thank you for clarifying so much of it, Kim. And
okay.
If Christy Clark should lose in Westside Kelowna today, we will definitely be talking to you tomorrow. So get ready
okay,
for another
we'll
busy
then.
Day. All right. Thanks, Kim Emerson,
okay.
OmniBC legislative reporter.